There he is. You got him.
That's a big one, boy.
Right, so just gonna head and gut this tuna here. I'm gonna start just by cutting around the anus here. All the intestines and that are connected into there, so just cut a nice ring around there. Cool, you can see it attached there. I think we're gonna have to take the head off this one to fit it in our chili bin here, so I'm gonna start just by cutting this gill membrane right the way through there. And then there's layers of bone here, and you're gonna go in between the two. See if I can get it right. Yep, there we go. Beautiful. And all the way forward there, just like that. If you've got a pair of like secateurs or cutters, like I've always got on my belt, just gonna cut through the throat latch here. It's real bony, it's just much easier to do with a set of cutters. Then we'll flip them over. Do the same on the other side. Just there's that sort of little layers of bone there. All the way through to the other cut. Right, I'm just gonna nick that down as deep as I can get it. Just hold the body of it.
There you go, not a bit of meat wasted. Look at that, it all just comes out with the...
Yep, just
beautiful.
Like that.
Beautiful.
Right, let's have a little look at what he's been eating. All right, so this is a little lanternfish, red lanternfish.
And yet he made the mistake of deciding to get greedy and eating a relatively big bait, which was our live bait. Oh yeah, give us that, bro.
You'd eat that.
Yeah, yeah, mate.
Bound.
Always eat the heart of the first tuna you catch. It gives you the mojo of the sea, the strength of the sea, and right now I need it because my foot's real sore. And besides that, it's actually delicious. It's not a stunt, I promise.